Welcome to Mommionaire Digital Marketing Podcast, where we gather to learn how to use online strategies to build our direct marketing business. Through this podcast, you will be learning how to create offers, funnels, and storytelling so that you can create value for your potential customers as well as your downline. Enjoy the show. Copywriting that converts to big money. So today we are going to focus on copywriting. Now there's a difference between copywriting and content writing. So with copywriting, what you're doing is you are creating a written piece that is going to convince and persuade your ideal audience to purchase the products or the services that you are promoting or selling. Whereas with content writing, you're writing content. So you're writing a blog, information about the steps to take to lose weight, or secrets to even skin, or you're writing a blog, or you're doing a podcast about how to create videos that will convert. So you're giving information, but you're not selling, you're not closing on each section of your presentation. So with this in mind, it's really important that you know this, because last week we talked about target audience that converts to big money. And we talked about how to conduct the right research to understand your ideal audience for your products and your services, and how to create avatar profile about your audiences, because not everyone's your ideal audience. I remember when I was in direct marketing, it was for skincare and cosmetic products. My director told me that, you know, the product works for everyone. Yes, it does, but not everyone is my target market. So I understood that concept because I had my own business and I'd done a marketing research. So I knew who were my ideal customers and I went right after them. So this is why I am really focusing on this, because I think that a lot of people sometimes are in business and they're just calling everyone and letting everyone know that they're in business when they could spend more time being the attractive character, providing right content for their ideal customers because they really understand them and they make connection with their ideal customer. And instead of going out there and just really going from one person to the other and going through that hit or miss process. So now that we're looking at this, I know that last week we had talked about anti-aging product, and I love cosmetics, so of course I'm going to talk about anti-aging products. I am in my 50s, but women, when they get to the age of their 30s to their, you know, 50s and 60s, we think really about anti-aging product. Now, when we talked about target audience, we talked about creating avatar profile of each specific target audience for your products. I mentioned about skincare products. I talked about there's a difference between white women's need for anti-aging products versus a woman of color's need for anti-aging products. So a white woman may be worried about fine lines, wrinkles, dullness of skin, may have slight discoloration, but not something that people can see too deep. Sometimes they do have little spots, but really the fine lines and wrinkles are the major thing. But within that group, there are also subgroups, right? You can't just say all white women have that specific need, because when you're selling skincare, you're also selling cosmetics. And though the bulk of the money is in skincare, but there's so much more you can make with cosmetics as well, right? So skincare is the cake and the cosmetic is the icing. That's how I see it. So women in the A group, and when we talk about white women, are that the soccer mom women who do not have time to sit there and put a full face of makeup. So what they're looking for is really to deal with the fine lines and wrinkles, because they don't want people to see them getting older. They want to still have that young appearance. So they're looking for products that are quick and easy for them to be able to use. So those are the customers that you cannot sell cosmetics to because they don't really want that. They may want a tainted moisturizer or CC cream, but they don't want anything more than that. Then you have the women in the B group who want to look professional. So they want to take care of their skin, deal with the fine lines and wrinkles, but they want a nice foundation. They want a little eyeshadow, mascara, light blush, and a soft lip color so that they can continue to look beautiful, but in a natural way that is not bright and out there. Then you have the group of women that's the C avatar who really is into looking glamorous, who loves wearing makeup. They tend to be a little bit older because they're more confident, willing to take risks with color. It also, those are the groups that you can think about. So within your own product line, you want to find out, okay, this is my target group, but then what are the subgroups within my target group who have specific needs? So here are the list of essential questions that I've added to help you to understand your specific target market and to create avatar profile of each market. Then we think about, hey, if you're going to be creating copyright, remember you need that hook, you need the story and the offer. So I mentioned that in our last video, but I didn't go in depth about it. So today, what we are going to do, we're going to use the information that we've gathered about our target audience to create copyright scripts that converts. We're going to think about that process of hook, story, offer. Think about the great questions that you need to have answers to in order to get started with your copyright. And then think about the process of solutions and testimonials for your copyright. Because remember, copyright, what you want to do is always have that call to action where people are going to take out their card and purchase your product or your services, or your call to action could be people having to give you a call for an interview to see if you're the right fit for them and if they're the right fit for you. When we've already talked about the avatar, that is your target audience. Now we're going to talk about the hook, the story, and the offer so that you can reach all of the different versions of your ideal audience. And that is the purpose here. Here are some great questions you should be able to answer for your copyright, right? What's the number one thing your target audience want about your product and your service? What is the number one thing? Remember when you talk about anti-aging products and the number one thing is to fight the signs of aging. So here's what I wrote here. Fight the signs of aging in less than 30 days. So the problem, the solution, and how long it's going to take for them to see the result. So this is a hook to really get that attention of my target market. Now, when I've done that, I have that hook. Now we want to think about what benefits, right? Then you want to think about what problem is this product going to solve for your ideal audience. So you want to go to, again, break it down, avatar A, avatar B, and avatar C, giving description of the problem that it solves for each. So if you have women with fine lines and wrinkles, you're talking about how this solves that problem. You have women who are dealing with discoloration, you're providing that information on there. You have women who may see puffiness underneath the eyes, you're providing that information for that avatar. So you want to target each problem that your specific avatar have, right? Think about how, now that you've done that, how does that problem make the avatar feel inside about themselves? Maybe less confident, you know, think about the challenge, the internal challenges as well as the external challenges, right? So when you're thinking about that, why is the problem worse than what they think? Why is it even worse? You know, so use one for external and then use another question with other information you would provide would be internal. Okay. So here's another great question. What is the name of your solution? So what's the name of your product or your services, right? And what does your ideal audience get? So remember, do not be wordy in this section. You want to be specific about the benefit for avatar A, fine lines and wrinkles, benefit for avatar B, even skin. Benefit for Avatar C, reduce puffiness and state the benefits. But usually when you have your benefits, also remember you're writing those benefits because you want to get to that point of your call to action where they're taking their credit card to purchase the product that you're promoting. So next, we talk about solutions and testimonials. Once you finish saying the benefits, you want to say, what solution does this have for your avatar A? What solution does it create for avatar B? What solution does it create for avatar C, right? And you want to be specific. And this is all based on your market research because you know what solutions they want based on your market research. Once you've done this, then you want to think about the testimonials because this is where it comes for your call to action. Your testimonials is a great way to debunk any fears or objection that your ideal audience may have. You know, you don't want it to come from you. You want it to come from the people who have used your products, who know about your products, and who may have had these fears or false beliefs that would have prevented them from purchasing your product. So you want to think about the internal false belief, right? Will this product work for me? Can I do this? What if this product doesn't work? Think about someone who's trying to lose weight, who's tried to lose weight several times. Think about what it feels if they try this product and it doesn't work and their husband is looking at them like, this is the fourth time you tried, you know, a regimen and it didn't work. So they're wondering how that's going to feel, the external fears, right? Can I do this? But all the other things that comes in are external, that they maybe they don't have the time, or those are all the things you want to think about, all their objections, because you want a testimonial with people who have gone through those situations with the objections and saying, you know what, I didn't have the time to exercise, but you know what, I invested 30 minutes a day in the morning or in the evening on myself, and I've lost 20 pounds. Or, you know, being that it's coming from someone else, really close it. And if you have a testimonial for each one of your avatars, whether it's avatar A, then you have one for avatar B, you have one for avatar C, basically you're sealing the deal. So at that point, you have these testimonials. The next thing you need to do is do your call to action, create some form of urgency. Click here to try the product for 30 days. Click here to learn more about services. Click here for a quick call. You know, whatever it is that your call to action is, make sure that you have a strong call to action so that they can quickly click. But then you could go down again and now put your social proof. Social proof is great, especially if you're on Facebook and you are rocking it on Facebook. You have people who love your products and your services, people who speak highly of you, who think highly of you. You have those engaging posts of people who are saying great testimonials about your services, your product, and who you are. These are things that you need to put on your website, letting people know, right? These are things too you can put in your email list. When you're sending emails, you can put that in your emails as well as you're creating your copyright for your email newsletter. Now, when you do that, when you have these testimonial posts, you have your testimonial, you have the Facebook post, go back again. Remember, create that sense of urgency. Because, you know, when you create that sense of urgency and scarcity, it causes people to take the next step. Limited time offer is an example. Quantities are limited. Another one. Only 47 left. Same example as I said in QVC. That's why I love watching QVC because it shows you how they create that sense of urgency and scarcity. Sales end on, and it's like sales end in one day, sales end in 24 hours, sales ends on August 31st, or doors close on Thursday. Don't miss out. And once you do that, put your call to action, whether it is give us a call or click here, absolutely have your call to action. I am teaching you these because I really am so excited about the next few weeks. My goal for the next few weeks is we're going to be doing a challenge. And if you would love to be part of the challenge, If you would love to join the challenge, absolutely join our Facebook group. It's called Momunaire Digital Marketing. In this group, we are going to be doing a challenge, and this challenge is going to be about how to get organic leads from Facebook. And we're going to go through each step of the way, and I'm going to teach you every way how to get organic leads for your business. So before I do this, I really wanted you guys to know, hey, who is your target market? Who are the people that you can market your products to? And I wanted to make sure that you have already done your market research. I also wanted you to understand this whole concept of, hey, you're doing this because what are you looking to do? Monetize your Facebook. You're looking to monetize your website. You're looking to monetize your email list. So this is why I'm sharing this, because these are key things that you need to know. There are a few things I want to talk to you about. So once you've done this, there are a few things when you're doing your copyright that you need to know. Use short sentences for your copyright. Use fear of missing out, which I've mentioned earlier. Make your paragraph to be 5 to 6 sentences. You want it to be short and easy. No one wants to read a long copyright. People want to see it short and easy. They like images. If people are the testimonials, if people are creating video testimonials, those are great. Use mini stories, and your mini story should be about a few lines. Don't use big words. Keep it as simple as possible. Now, today we've talked about how to use the information we've gathered about our target audience to create copyright scripts that convert. We've talked about the process of hook, story, offer. I went over some great questions to get you started with your copywriting. And we talked about solutions and testimonials. Remember, if you follow these strategies, they will make a difference in how you close your sales. It is really important to connect with your ideal audience, but it's also important to close them into sales and let them get to take that next step and overcome that fear that they have that is stopping them to get to that next level. So thank you for listening to us. Again, we are going to be having a 21-day challenge. I will be talking more about this in the next few days. So if you are interested, we're excited and we're looking forward to these next 21 days. So please click the link below. It's Momunaire Digital Marketing, and it's in Facebook groups. Thank you and have a great day. Bye-bye. If you would like to get more information on how to build your direct marketing business using online strategies as well as social media, please go to our website, MomunaireDigitalMarketing.com. Also, don't forget to subscribe and also make some comments of what you would like to hear in our next show. Thank you. Bye-bye.